Så träffar vi Daniel Negreanu här på... By the way, how do I pronounce your last name correctly?
Svensson. No, I'm just kidding. Last name is Negreanu.
Negreanu.
Negreanu. It's a U at the end.
Okay, Daniel, how do you feel about this World Series of Poker Europe 2009?
I feel it is annually the toughest tournament in the world. Every single year, you have a field of about 300 to 400 players. You have just the best of the best. It's a high buy-in event. Different than the main event at the World Series, where you have 8,000, but a lot more difficult to win.
It's a bit chaotic here. What's the matter with the table placements?
Well, unlike what you see in a Las Vegas casino where they can rent out a convention center, there isn't as much space here at the Empire Casino. So I'm looking for table 7, and I looked, I saw 5, 9, 38, 6, 10, and I can't find it, but eventually they'll get me there.
We had the pleasure of watching you playing the Caesars Cup earlier on here. What's your feelings about that one?
It was disappointing. It's a fast structure, so there's a certain style of poker that's necessary to win, and you have to really know the math. And I felt the European team definitely did, and they played a much better game than we did overall. Our side made some mistakes, and that's what caused us. We were also unlucky. I mean, it's not just just the mistakes. It was also bad luck in the coin flip situations.
Daniel, you're a mega super poker star, of course. Could you tell us a little bit about the 2009 poker year for you, online, live? How's it gone?
Well, I've been doing okay. It's not a disappointing year. I did have 8 cashes at the World Series of Poker. I've never done that before. I didn't get a bracelet. I came second and fourth, very close. But the year isn't over yet, and I still have a chance here in this event here. So I won't really know how good of a year it is until December.
I've asked all the major, big stars here, how do you motivate yourself to keep playing year after year? I mean, you've been doing this for quite a while now.
Well, for me, it's exciting to see a lot of young, great players coming up in the game. And I feel you always have to continue to prove yourself. What I've done in the past has nothing to say about right now. I haven't been killing it this year. Other people have. So in order for me to, get the respect that I want or desire, for example, as a poker player, I have to continue to perform. And that's an ongoing struggle. You have to do it every year.
Do you have a goal for 2010 set up already, or...?
No, nothing, concrete. Just to be physically as fit as I can be, get my golf handicap really, a lot lower, and just really focus on playing a lot more high-limit poker, actually.
You look like one of the fittest players on the tour, actually. Tell us a little bit about that. You're a vegetarian, I've heard.
Well, I'm a vegan. I don't do dairy also, and I do have a trainer now, which helps, get me a little bit stronger. And it's important when you're playing 14 hours a day to be physically fit. Poker's changed in that way, that, you look at the new breed of poker player, and they're strong and young.
I assume you're going to play the EPT as well after this one.
Actually, I will be leaving early. I'm playing the high roller, but I have to go to Los Angeles. We're shooting PokerStars, shooting the PokerStars Million Dollar Challenge, which I'm really excited about, and we're shooting that right away after this in LA.
Okay, now they're calling you, Daniel, so I guess you have to run off your table. Thank you very much.
I can find it. All right.